objections to being in this class, speak now or forever hold your peace. I think that pretty much covers the hows and whys of your situation. But this program isn't cheap to run, so we're not about to force anyone into it if they don't want to be here. You should also be aware that Class 7's curriculum will be tougher than any other class's coursework. Just fair warning. So now you know, and that leaves you all with an important decision to make. Will you stick with Class 7 or not? Oh, if you opt out, you'll just be placed in the class you would have been assigned to otherwise. There's no pressure. Nobles will land in class 1 or 2, commoners in 3, 4, or 5. It's still just the first day, so there's no real catching up you'd have to do. I'm sure you'd fit in just fine.
I'll do it. Whatever Class 7 has to throw at me, I'm game.
Whoa, wait, what?
Just like that?
So you're the first, then. You seem pretty sure about it. Any particular reason?
Not really. I just feel like I've put my family out asking them to send me to this school. So, if it gives me more to show for my time here, I'll take whatever opportunities come my way.
A noble sentiment.
Count me in as well. The greater the challenge, the more I can push myself to excel. One can't hone a blade without grit, after all.
Let's make it three. Considering how far I came to attend this school, it'd be silly to back down before I even started.
Well, looks like we've got the country's strongest freshman on board, and our foreign exchange student, too. Any more takers?
Allow me to take part as well. I was only able to come because of the school's generosity, so I feel it's my duty to help in any way I can.
Sign me up, too! I feel like fate brought us here for a reason, you know? And we all seem pretty easy to get along with.
And that's a yes from our two Orville staff testers. Though I feel compelled to remind you, your weapons are still in the prototype stage. So on top of your other work, I'll be expecting reports from both of you.
Of course.
Maybe I spoke too soon.
Let me join too.
Oh, there's a surprise. I was almost certain your rebellious streak would see you opt out just on general principle.
It does bother me that you've got us using these Arcus units that are still pretty clearly in development. But if I let every little nitpick like that hold me back, I'd never amount to much.
Words to live by right there. And that brings us to an even six. Now, what about you, Fee?
Don't really care either way. You can choose.
Not this time. This is one call you're gonna have to make for yourself. That was the deal, remember? You need to take control of your own life.
Fine, I'm in.
Well, at least you committed. We've got a magnificent seven now. Which leaves just the two of you. I can see you got issues with each other, but that doesn't mean you can't at least try to work together. Why, if you just look past your differences and embrace the joys of youth, I'm sure you'll become the best of friends!
Like hell we will! The exploitation of the common people by the aristocracy is a blight on every facet of Erebonian life! Unless something is done about it, this country has no future!
I appreciate your candor. But I don't think you're going to achieve much by lecturing me about it.
Well, at least that makes this simple. I, Eusis Albarea, claim my place as a member of Class 7.
the son of a duke! Just the thought of being in the same class as Commoner should make you sick!
I'll thank you not to tell me how I'm supposed to feel. As far as the House of Albarea is concerned, there's little difference between other nobles and commoners. Besides, this should at least ensure I won't have fools flitting about every day trying to win my favor. That said, I have little interest in getting drawn into your petty arguments on a daily basis either. I think it would be prudent for us to go our separate ways. I'm certain we can at least agree on this, no?
I don't need some pompous ass who coasts through life on his father's coattails telling me what to do. I'm in, come hell or high water. You might have had your successes spoon-fed to you up to now, but no outmoded class system is going to hand you trophies anymore.
We'll see about that.
They're going to be like this pretty much all year, aren't they?
Sure seems that way. I wouldn't bet on them ever seeing eye to eye.
Oh.
The pots shouldn't be too hard on the kettles.
Give a guy a break.
Well, how about that? 9 out of 9! With that, I'd like to congratulate all of you on being the first ever Class 7. I hope you keep those high spirits all year, because with the workload we've got planned for you, you'll need it.
Well, well, I wasn't expecting Class 7 to turn out quite as diverse as this. It certainly promises to be an interesting year.
You took the words right out of my mouth. But perhaps this, too, is the divine providence of the goddess, no?
How do you mean?
Seeing them there, I feel they have the potential to be the light we seek. A light that can break through the storm clouds that continue to build over our nation day by day.
Yeah!
ring! Good morning. Are you heading to school now too? How about we walk there together? No problem. I'm guessing everyone else left already, huh? Okay then. He's not sensing anyone? What does that mean exactly?
Good morning.
Morning. Are you two on your way to school?
Yeah. Come on, Emma. We're going to be late. Hey, wait for me, Elisa. We'll see you in class.
I never would have guessed she'd hold a grudge this long. She knows it was just an accident, right? She has to. Can't believe she'd be so sensitive. Well, as long as you keep trying, I'm sure she'll understand. Class 7's got enough tension as it is, what with our two, prideful warriors at each other's throats. So I think it would be a load off everyone's mind if you and Elisa could make up at least.